Hello, my name is Eduard Murcia. I'm a student intern at the University of Florida. And with this video, I want to share with you my experience in the Smart Irrigation and Hydrology Lab, which is led by Dr. Sandra Guzman, and where I had the opportunity to attend multiple conferences, be part of a research group, and also interact with citrus and vegetable growers through extension. I was in my last year of agriculture and civil engineering at the National University of Colombia when I knew about this opportunity of joining to this lab. I immediately decided to apply because I knew that it was the perfect opportunity for me to gain knowledge and experience in the newest irrigation techniques and together with high quality research.
When I joined Dr. Guzman's lab, I was involved right away into extension. I had the chance to attend the citrus show in 4 years and see how the lab transfer research result into easy practices for growers. Their growers were asking us so many questions about soil moisture sensors, and that was really exciting. After this conference experience, I had the opportunity to collaborate in multiple projects, but today I want to show you the two that I was mostly involved into. The first is about setting up and developing a proof of concept to test the feasibility of a novel ultrafine bubble injection system to improve the quality of three water sources used in Southeast Florida with agricultural purposes. Ultrafine bubbles or nanobubbles are bubbles at the scale of proteins or virus, just like the coronavirus, that have some special physical and chemical characteristics such as low rising velocities caused by the Brownian motion or high internal pressure and temperature. So we use a device able to create those tiny bubbles to inject oxygen into 26-gallon water tanks that we collect from three local sources: one agricultural drainage canal, a stormwater pond, and a groundwater well. Our driving question was whether or not the nanobubble injection technology can effectively improve the quality of agricultural waters by increasing and maintaining high dissolved oxygen levels for days and weeks. We found that with the nanobubble injection system, oxygen levels can reach up to 30 milligrams per liter in a short time. This could be very beneficial, especially with citrus growers, because they need to use groundwater that can have oxygen levels as low as 2 milligrams per liter, but it will know that dissolved oxygen levels should be higher than 5 milligrams per liter in order to meet the minimum requirements of plants and many different ecosystems. We also found that during the injection process there was an increment of temperature and pH in all the different types of water. This may be related to one of the interesting properties of nanobubbles. This is their internal high pressure and temperature, which had been associated with the creation of hydroxyl ions and the degradation of organic matter. The pH behavior is also an interesting finding, as pH regulates many chemical and biological processes in the water. These results are important as they provide insights for possible scenarios where this technology could be used. For instance, using this technology with irrigation water seems promising, as increasing oxygen to ideal levels could contribute to the health of the plant system and diminish the contamination caused by the runoff of irrigation to important ecosystems such as the Indian River Lagoon. My second project was a research extension project. Here we had been using soil moisture sensors and fabric mulching as citrus orchard as part of the implementation of best management practices to reduce water usage. With the soil moisture sensors and the IoT system, we continuously evaluate the water content from two points in the field, one near to young lemon trees that were planted over bare soil, and the other near to trees planted over the fabric mulch cover bed. Based on the information from the sensors, we make daily assessments of irrigation needs for each treatment. Also, we compare physiological responses and soil temperature between treatments. From this project, we have found not only that soil moisture sensors are a promising and useful tool to reduce water usage while keeping the health of the crops, but that several considerations must be taken into account when choosing the type of soil moisture sensors system and during its installation and maintaining. This experience at IREC had been challenging and uplifting. Here I could attend important conferences as an assistant and as a poster expositor, attend important meetings with growers and extension agents, and work together with scientists from important agencies such as USDA and other UF research centers. Also, I received training in water quality assessment techniques, soil moisture sensors management, important research skills like reading and writing scientific manuscripts, communication skills, and experimental design techniques. For all this marvelous experience, I want to thank everyone that has helped me during my time here. especially to my advisor that had guided me through the magical world of research and extension, and to each member of my team that had supported me all the time. Also to Dr. Cave that as a center director gave me the opportunity to come here, and to Velma for all the support with the administrative processes, and in general to everyone that in one or another way had helped me during my internship.